to do a pick a card reading, guys. Today we're asking the question, was this love or were they just a F boy or F girl? Okay. Was this love or were they just a F boy or F girl? We will do an extended reading on this. We will take a deeper dive into the overview. We will ask, how have they grown or changed? And we will also ask, what will happen next with us? So keep in mind, this is a general reading, may not resonate with everyone. Should it resonate with you, please like, share, subscribe to the comments. Subscribe to the channel. Give me that thumbs up, because you two be tripping. If it doesn't fit, don't force it. If it doesn't fit, let it fly. If it doesn't fit, you must acquit. Take the bits and pieces that resonate with you. Leave everything else on the dance floor and moonwalk your job behind on away from it. If you'd like to get a personal reading with me, you can do so by following all the links down below. If you're interested in a life coaching session with me, because I am a certified professional life coach, meaning I went to school to study the art of life coaching, just didn't stamp those initials on the back of my name, you can do so by following the links down below. If you're interested in about 80% of the decks that I use on this channel, you can find them linked down below in a list titled, "These Are a Few of My Favorite Things." And if you like, and I just lost my voice, if you would like to donate to the channel in any way, you can find my Amazon wish list and also the donation buttons linked below as well. Let me drink some tea. Excuse me. I be doing these at like 5 and 6 in the morning, so y'all be the first people I talk to. So my voice, it takes a moment for it to get a little stabilized. Yeah, and while we're on the topic, you all, while you all are choosing these cards, make sure you don't go through the readings and just choose what feels good. And make sure you are taking a deep breath and you are really choosing a card that resonates with you. It should be a card that pops out to you, something that like feels familiar or similar to your energy. It shouldn't just be what you want to hear, because if you just go to readings on any person's page, if you just go to readings that just tell you what you want to hear, you're not growing, you're not developing, you're not unfolding, you know. And you have to listen to these with an open mind, so that if there's a lesson in for you as well, you can get that. If you just kind of float through readings and you just want to hear, you know, everything that just makes you feel warm and fuzzy inside and creates this false illusion of this person returning or this person coming to you or this person being like die hard in love with you, that's not going to get you anywhere, because it's a misalignment. And in the same breath, and you can't just listen to something and because you hate the person or because you haven't healed or because you haven't done the work that you're still supposed to do, start blowing up comments with all this negative stuff and talking about how you hate this person and this and that. Like, you got to look at that. You know, these are really meant, especially for my channel, I can't really speak for any other reader, but these are meant to assist you, right? And it's always just a period in time. It's not, I can't predict anybody's future. That's just not how it works. I can pick up on people's energy and I can read the energy that you're emitting at that moment. But with every next moment, with every single second that happens, with every new choice that you make, your future changes. That's why we have so many different timelines. That's why you're able to jump into higher timelines. That's why you guys are able to meet and then things, you know, don't stay in alignment and you break off. Like, there's so many different timelines out there, and there is absolutely no way that anybody can predict anybody's future. It's you who has the magic. It's you whose energy that I'm reading. And so keep that in the back of your mind versus, you know, just going to something that makes you feel good. That's not the answer. The answer is to grow. The answer is to look within yourself and see where you can change, where you can elevate, what lesson is being brought to you, how you can be empowered. All right. So that's my rant. So we have 3 choices before us today. Choice number 1 is going to be the 5 of cups. It's not going to come into focus. There we go. 5 of cups. Choice number two is going to be the Four of Cups. And choice number three is going to be the Knight of Cups. So we have the Five of Cups, the Four of Cups, and the Knight of Cups. On the count of three, we're going to take our deep breath. One, two, three. Pick your card. Is it going to be the Five of Cups, the Four of Cups, or the Knight of Cups? Alrighty, daddy. So, universe, people who chose the Five of Cups, and if you guys skipped over my rant in the beginning, make sure you don't go through these and you just listen to everything and you listen to the one that feels warm and fuzzy inside and makes you feel good and is super, super positive and you just pick that one. Like, don't do that. Pick what really resonates with you because there may be a lesson in there that needs to be brought to your attention that you need to grow from or grow beyond. These aren't meant to just make you feel good. These are meant to stimulate you in some way. All right, so having said that, this reading resonates with you, please be sure to drop down into the comments. Give me that thumbs up. Leave a comment. Was this love or were they an F-boy or F-girl, universe? Was this truly love? What was this? Tell me what this was. People who chose reading number one, the Five of Cups. What was this truly, universe? What was this? Was this love or were they an F-boy or F-girl, universe? First card out. Feel like we shouldn't do reversals today. I don't know why I said that out loud. We have the Six of Coins. We have the Nine of Coins. We have the Three of Coins. Whoa, they're flying out. We have the Six of Cups. So the Five to the Six, because you chose the Five of Cups. Was this love or was this? We have the Page of Wands. Was this love or were they F boy, F girl? We have the World card. Excuse me. We have the Ten of Swords. And we have the Hermit. Oof. Bottom of the deck, we have the Three of Cups. I can see why you're here at this reading and try to figure this out with the Three of Cups being at the bottom of the deck. So this is a situation where I feel as though, if you need to grab a spatula, you might want to do that right now because you might need to flip this story. I'm going to read this from your perspective, the watcher's perspective. And I'll do my best to clarify it as much as possible. However, this looks like a situation where you, and it could have been the other person, but I'm going to say you were hyper independent. Which is a trauma response. Hyper independent, very much content with your life. I don't know if you were in love with your life, but it feels as though you were content with your life. You were able to pay your own bills, all of them. You had money left over. You could go shopping. You could take trips. You could do all of these things that you wanted to do. And it doesn't appear as though you were looking for love. When we get into the extended, everything can change. However, right now, for everybody who's tuning into this, it just looks like you were okay. I think this feels like you had done a lot of healing work. You had done a lot of focus on yourself. A lot of things were brought into your awareness. With you being hyper independent and that being a trauma response, there could have been something very traumatic that happened in your life or in relationships that caused you to gain or obtain some type of wisdom very quickly in a short amount of time. And I think that the wisdom caused you to age. You could have seen a lot of changes within your body. You could have seen a lot of changes. Like, you may have gotten a lot of gray hair. You may have gained a little bit of weight. But it just seems like life in the capacity of love slowed down. And the person that you were in a relationship with, because it seems like something extremely traumatic, if I'm honest. It seems like something that would have been along the lines of like a nut, because there's a quantum leap that happens between these two cards. So it seems like something that could have been like a narcissistic relationship, something that's physically abusive, something like that. And if that's the case, I really hate that you've gone through that. But it seems that you made it through and that you obtained some lots of wisdom about that. And you just kind of pulled yourself out of wanting to date, wanting to be with somebody else. Like, you were content again with being by yourself, with taking care of yourself. I think that you have a good job. I don't think you're rich, but I don't think you're at all poor. I don't think you're struggling a bit. I think that you went from a period of imbalance of giving, overstimulating relationships, taking all the action in relationships, doing everything in relationships, to calling all of that energy back into yourself. It's kind of the transition that I see here. And I think that your idea on love may have become a little jaded, but, or maybe you perceive it sometimes as being jaded, but I don't think it's being jaded at all. I think it's more so being cautious, because you may have been so very carefree. You may have been so very just giving of your energy. And I think you were robbed of your energy in the long run. I think that you've given without receiving quite a bit. And so when you met this person that's in question right now, it feels as though you made yourself available, but only to a certain extent, because you have gained so much wisdom. And sometimes wisdom can come in an imbalance, because you know, we try to do everything so precisely and, you know, practically, and there's a technique to everything, which I hate techniques. I hate steps. I hate, you know, going through things this way for the most part. I think that you got wrapped up in that and you just wanted to make sure that nobody would take advantage of you. And so there's a bit of defensive that comes with this wisdom, and that's not a bad thing, but you're protective of yourself, because the growth that you've done has made you aware of your worth and your value. And so I think that this person was brought into your life for you to apply these new lessons to, but also to calm your heart. Sheesh. My voice, hold on, let me drink some tea. Was also brought into your life to calm your heart. I think that they may have done some things, said some things, or conducted themselves in a way in which it made you question certain things. This person may have had children outside of you all's situationship. This person may have had They had a lot of life happening outside of the situationship. And when certain things would happen because of the way that they're used to conducting themselves, and with the boundaries, these newfound boundaries that you set in place, I think that you needed a lot more reassurance and you needed a lot more assistance in stabilizing in this connection. And I think that this person, as they grew closer to you, I think that they were doing their best, which is not your best, it's their best, to work with you, to reassure you, to make you feel safe, to make you feel protected. Because I think that they understood this, because it doesn't look like you all had like a lot of conversations about this past relationship. I don't even think that this person from your past who caused all of this is even worthy of that. of being spoken about like that. But I think that you were defensive. I think you could have been sharp, very calculated, very strategic, very pragmatic, very practical, just in the way you set up your boundaries and letting them know you were very passionate about, yeah, no, I don't feel good about this. Or you, in the early stages or phases of this connection, you might have really been like, reactive, right? Like, yeah, I'm not doing this, you know, or no, I don't want to do this anymore. Like really quick to cut things off. I wouldn't be surprised if we see the Queen of Swords in the extended. Really quick to cut things off, really quick to stop things. Like, cause you're not going to let anything get out of hand because you're just new and you're protective. You know, you shed a layer of your skin, and I liken that to being a snake, right? You shed a layer of skin and then all of a sudden the hunter becomes the prey. And so you're just protective of yourself. And I think that this person was able to, coax you, to comfort you, to speak to this younger you and make you feel reassured. I think that they did offer you that reassurance. I think that they did, you know, if you wanted to talk about something, they would talk about it until they were blue in the face with you. It was just like they were there for you. And I think that it made you open the door. It allowed you to open the door to this innocence. And I think that you came to life again. You blossomed again. You began the phases of what if I allow this person in, and you let them in. And I think that there could be distance between you all beyond this separation that I'm seeing here. There could be distance, like, logistically, there, like, you guys could be worlds apart from one another right now, or it feels like you're worlds apart. Whereas there was all of this cohesiveness and all of this cooperation, all of a sudden with this Ten of Swords here, there's just like complete distance. And I think that when this separation happened, what ended up happening and why you're here watching this reading is this person completely changed. This person completely changed. I think that maybe you brought something to this person's attention and it was just something that was on your heart, something that was bothering you. And whereas this person would, you know, once upon a time offer you reassurance, talk about it with you until they were blue in the face, wanted to make sure that you were happy, that you were good, that they were understood, that you, were capable of comprehending, the space in which they were coming from, that they didn't mean you any ill will, anything like that. I think that you may have brought something to their attention, and I think that it wasn't accepted in the same way. And I think that things got out of hand, and I think that you, simply put, I think that you may have felt, why did I do that? I feel so stupid. I should have known better. Like, you feel like this person got you. You feel like this person betrayed you. This person tricked you, showed up as one person, may have love bombed you, wasn't really this person who really cared about your feelings. And I think that with this separation and this feeling of being worlds apart, and I do feel that there's like logistic separation distance, not being able to get to one another, and this person not showing up how they used to, I think that it caused you to feel extremely betrayed. And really just done, like you thought you were complacent and content with being pulled out of dating and relationships prior. Now you're just really like, whoa, cause how did that get past me? Like, how did this person pretend, is how you perceived it, pretend to want to work with me and build this life with me and talked about all these things? And, you know, I think that there was a lot of conversation about the future. And I think that you feel that it was future faking, that this person was just lying to you the entire time. And like, how did I fall for this again, is how you feel. And I think that there was separation, because this Hermit card is really, I'm seeing both of you all in this card. It's like, it just, communication stopped and there was no attempt to try to reconcile. There was no attempt to try to fix things. There was no attempt to obtain higher clarity and to reassure one. And there was no attempt for that. And I think that in this thinking, because I do think that it's been some overthinking on both your parts, I think that this person has like just chilled. I don't know if you're looking at this person on social media. I don't know if you all have like mutual friends or what, but it seems as though this person has just like, they're good with everything. That's what the appearance looks like, and that they weren't real. So the question is, was this love or were they an F boy or F girl? Quite honestly, I think that at your best, you were love. I think this is a bit of both. I think this is somebody who is very capable of being a F boy or F girl. I think this is somebody who is very capable of being a partier, you know, out in the world, wanting a lot of attention, things like that. I think that this person enjoys the goodness of life. I think this person can be a little overindulgent. Just with this Three of Cups, like really, really threw a monkey wrench in the whole thing. But at the same time, I really do think that the connection that you all had and experienced, I do think that it was brought into your life. And I do think that this person came into your life with a sense of integrity. And I do think that this person felt for you exactly what they said they felt for you. Now, whether there's fear that caused them to kind of take this path of escape, whether it was, you know, they didn't feel that they could continue reassuring you or they could continue helping you or assisting you, if they felt that they stepped out of your way to protect you so that they wouldn't harm you. I don't know. And I won't be able to see more into that until we take a deeper dive in the extended, and I'm not baiting you, but I think that when they were with you, the things that they said and the way that they felt and the reassurance that they offered, I think all of that was real. There's something with this world card that I really want to dive deep into, just to see this distance or like what they were feeling. But I do think that when you all split, that... And I mean, they didn't have any allegiance to you at that point. You guys are separated, right? But it doesn't mean that they don't care about you. This person could have gone back into partying or whatever to forget about you, or to, like, you know, something like that. I don't know. But I think it's a bit of both. I think when they were with you, yes, I think that it was the blossoming of love. I think that love was absolutely on the table. I think that everything that they were saying was real. I think that when they left you, they either returned to or they became this overindulgent F boy or F girl. That's the best I can do with these cards. Mm-hmm. So we're gonna do an extended on this. We're gonna take a deeper dive into the overview. We're gonna ask, how have they grown or changed? And we're also gonna ask what will happen next with you all. If you'd like to join me over in the extended, the link is gonna be down below. If you wanna get a personal reading with me, you can do so by following the link down below. If you'd like to get a life coaching session with me, it's linked down below. If you don't wanna follow me anywhere and you don't want nothing else to do with me today, don't worry about it. Just stay down, y'all. It's a marathon. That's interesting. All right, let's shift, because we gotta shift. Because things shift and we shift. So universe, the people who chose reading number 2, 4 of Cups, was this love or are they truly a F boy or F girl? Was this love or were they truly a F boy or F girl, universe? Was this love or were they truly? If you all missed the intro, I don't think I'm doing... No, the universe said you are doing it, so you hush. If you all missed the intro, I had a little rant. It was a calm rant, but just make sure you're not going through and listening to all the readings and just commenting about the one or choosing the one that feels the best and has the best message and it's all positive and great, because these readings are done For both perspectives, for your side and their side. And it should always assist you in growing, developing, and unfolding yourself, to change your perspective, to elevate your frequency, whatever the case, to bring something into your awareness, whatever the case may be. Just make sure you don't just go through and just pick and choose what feels good, because that's not healthy. Was this love or were they? And don't comment a bunch of negative stuff about how you hate this person and how this person did you so wrong. And oh my God, you just hope they drop dead and all this stuff, because that just tells me that something is not healed within you, right? And so let's just be aware of what we're saying and where we are in our space of healing, right? Because you can say all of those things, but then you should say something about what you're doing next in order to grow, develop, and unfold. Was this love or were they an F boy or F girl? Was this love or were they an F boy or F girl? Was this love, universe, or were they an F boy or F girl? What was this? Please make these messages as simple and as clear as possible. Two of cups. How y'all facing each other? Then turn y'all backs to each other. Ooh, because the devil card. The devil? Was this love? Two of swords. We have the vulnerable man or the hierophant in reverse. Was this love or were they an F-boy or F-girl, universe? Oof. We have the King of Swords. We have the... right next to each other. The King and Queen of Swords right next to each other. Why is this off-centered? That's weird. Oh, my goodness. Was this love or Ace of Cups? This was a lesson, I'll tell you that much. Knight of Pentacles at the bottom of the deck. This was a huge lesson for both of y'all. The song I'm hearing is Don't Wanna Be a Player by Joe. Don't Wanna Be a Player. Not by Fat Pun. Big Pun. Big Pun? Fat Pun. Fat Joe, Big Pun. Not by Big Pun, but by Joe. And I don't even like Joe. Don't wanna be a player. I don't wanna be a player no more. The remix of that song was dope, though. I used to love when they did remixes of songs and it was totally different from the original. All right. So, let's just talk through these cards. I'll answer the question at the end. The answer is yes. This was not love. This was F boy and F girl. So this particular situation, this was like a love bombing situation. This was not a situation that a lot of thought was put into. This was a situation where you guys met, you hit it off. There was no wisdom stepping into this. There were no guards, no boundaries. This is completely opposite from a healthy, secure relationship. I think that in this situation, both of you all are very carefree. This may have been a situation that might have been like a one-night stand or something, or I don't know. You all met and things just kind of took off very rapidly. This is a situation where whatever time that you all spent together, I think that there was music. I think that there was, you guys could have been on a beach somewhere, or maybe at a restaurant or something with like a water fountain or something like that. But I just think that wherever you all met, I think that, even if you were surrounded by people, you just kind of bubbled your world in and you guys had a really, really good time. And I think that for a short period of time, because I think this is short lived, this may have even been one of those situations where you like give the person 3 months to show their true self and then they do. And then you're just like, whoa, right? I think this was a situation where it wasn't supposed to be a relationship or a situationship, and feelings start getting thrown into the mix. And you might want to listen to that song, Floetry, Feelings by Floetry. It's a really good song where you're in love with your fears, right? And it's like the closer you all got to one another, because I think that when you guys were in this little bubble, everything was great. I think that, you know, this person, they may have said things like, I love you. But I think it was love bombing. I don't think that either of you quite honestly know what love is, because this whole situationship was brought into both your lives to teach you the remembrance of love, to take you on the journey of love. I think prior to that, you all were both just in your head and very strategic on how you approach one another. This is absolutely one of those situations where, the girl would say, you know, like, you got to pay my bills. And a guy would say, well, you got to do this. Like, it was very transactional, this relationship. But I think that there were moments very early on where you all were just like, you had a good time with each other and you felt that you were a good match for one another and you felt that you were truly in alignment with one another. But that quickly changed. And I think that when there was an offering of love, I think that you all turned your back on it. I don't think that either of you understood love. You may have understood ideas of love, but I don't think that either of you really have experienced love. And because of that, you mishandled it. You didn't know what to do with it, because an opportunity was there where this could have blossomed and it could have took a left to Albuquerque, but instead you got to the fork in the road and you went straight. And so it's kind of one of those things where it's a little insane, in that they always say the definition of insanity is doing the same thing the same way but hoping for a different result. You all did and went about this idea of love the same way that you've gone about every other situationship in your life, and so that's why it took on the same trajectory, the same end goal. And I think that both of you all allowed your fears to get in the way, the fears of this not working, of all the reasons why it wouldn't work, of all the reasons why you guys are not compatible. And you forgot, because, and you all may have even been friends too, where this was like friends that you guys had a night and you hung out and all of a sudden one thing led to another, and something happened, something took off from that moment, and then you guys turned your back on it. And your fears got in the way. And I think that the feminine aspect in this energy pulled away from this situation, like, immediately, because I think the feminine is way more blocked than the masculine. But I also think that the feminine is way more available, as much as that sounds kind of contradictory to what I just said, is much more available to flowing with this lesson, because I see the feminine down here with the Ace of Cups as well. So I think fears got in the way. The feminine aspect shifted away from this with the Two of Swords, made a decision to move away from this, but was still feeling a lot of emotions. And I think that the masculine is a lot less traditional. So this could be a masculine energy that is into like polyamory, doesn't want to be monogamous, is a commitment phobe. I think both of you all are commitment phobes, but I think that this person is like standing 10 toes down, doesn't want to change their mind about their mind, is just like, this is what it is and this is what I'm going to do. And just kind of approach this situation from a very mental space. And I think that the fact that both of you all are so much in your heads, both of you all are very strategic, both of you all have a lot of wisdom in life, I think both of you all are extremely intelligent. I think all of those things got in your way, and all of those things compounded the fears that came about, because this could have been something, but because the love wasn't allowed to blossom and the mind shrouded and clouded the love, I think that it wasn't allowed to. I think you guys made a subconscious choice to not allow this love to do what it does. Especially with you all coming out next to each other as the King and Queen of Swords. Like, that's a couple, right? So, I think that the masculine energy stood 10 toes down, was not willing to budge on this, is not willing to think about it. This is what I want. And I think that you may have, in me saying that you chose to move away, but you also were the most available to open up to love, maybe you kind of went against yourself and was like, well, maybe we should try this, or what do you think about this? And I think this masculine was just like, yeah, we can, but I'm gonna date other people too, or I'm gonna do this too, like, this is my life. And it was kind of a my way or a highway type thing. So was this love, or are they a F boy or F girl? I think that both of you all kind of came into this very free spirited, not looking for anything. And both of you all kind of thinking that you were F boys and F girls. I think that you have since, moved on and elevated. And this situationship could have brought you into the, because maybe you believed in, polyamory or polygamy, or, you know, not being monogamous with another. Maybe you just wanted to date. Maybe you just wanted to be free. Maybe you didn't see anything serious in this as well. So I think that both of you all came to this without any intentions. And I think that when the intentions enter the chat room, I think that this person was like, I really don't want that. And I don't think that they did it in a nasty way. I think that there are some fears that both of you all are haunted by. And two, I have to say that I also believe that this person and you, I think that you guys begin to like go against yourselves with that free spiritedness. I think that you guys were kind of like, oh my goodness, calling each other more in the very early stages, calling each other more, longing for each other more, yearning for each other more, kind of having or taking on an obsessive quality to this, where it's like thinking about the other person more, being more softer. And then all of a sudden y'all like shook up and was like, whoa, 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 whoa. Like, what is happening? I'm a player. I'm a player. Yeah. And I think you quickly got back into your heads. And I think that you both have since moved on, and you are now isolating yourself from this. I think that you're getting more clear on what it is that you really want. And quite honestly, since this separation, and since you all allowed your mental space to really take over and to do things that just made more sense, because I don't think that you broke away and you didn't feel. I think that you broke away and you just kept pushing on. I think both of you all have massive strength, but the King and Queen of Swords typically sit on butterfly thrones. And so I do think that there's transformation that's happening with both of you all. I think you're jumping into the Cups energy, whereas you are true and isolated in a sense, but you may be surrounded by friends. You may be allowing friends to come in, but I think that you are, it's a matter of you both allowing yourselves to be loved. And I think that you are allowing yourself to be loved now, but I think that the person or the being or the entity that you are allowing yourself to receive love from is yourself. Because I think that you've taken on like this perception of, Why am I so terrified? Like, why did this devil card terrify me so much? Why was I just going along with the status quo? Was I just saying that I didn't want anything because I didn't want to push this person away or run this person off by admitting that I do care about them more, that I am rising in love with them, that I do want to experience life with them, that I do, like, whatever it was? I think you're just being more real with yourself, and you are examining the spaces that causes fear and drove love out. And I think that your person, with you doing that, because there's such a strong magnetic pull between you all, because you guys are so similar. You're so similar. I think that your person is now, with this Knight of Pentacles energy that we see down here, I think that your person slowly but surely is starting to understand that the things that once mattered to them may not hold as much weight in their life anymore. Because that Two of Cups is very powerful in this reading. And I don't want to downplay that. It's like the only quote unquote good card in this reading, quite honestly, besides the Ace of Cups, but you alone. You with your girls, but you alone. So it's like that Two of Cups has monumental significance in that bubble that you all created. It was just peaceful. It was calm. It was whole. You guys are surrounded by nature. You have all the elements right there with you. It's just like there was music and there was laughter and there was friendship and there was understanding and interstanding. It's just like you all got one another. So I get why you're here, but I don't think anything that I'm saying to you is really eye-opening. I think it's just, yep. So I think that quite honestly, you both were F boys and F girls or whatever this situationship was comprised of. But I think that you both have since shifted on. Again, you are in the Cups energy now. You're pouring love back into yourself. You're realizing your worth and your value, and that it was always okay for you to say what you wanted. And you should never be afraid of that. And you should never allow fear to drive love out of your life. And with you doing that, because of this connection and because of, why did I just want to say soul tie, but because of this tie that you all have to one another, I think that this person is slowly but surely is maturing from the life that they once thought that they wanted and examining what else is out there. Like, what else could they want? Because that this connection was eye-opening to this person. And it's made them go within. Because they've refused. They refused twice. You refused, but then you did it. So like, they were refusing to be traditional. They kind of shunned that kind of life, marriage and, you know, the picket fence. And but I think that they would generate some of that, but not all of it. It's just like they would do a little bit of it, but they wouldn't go all the way. They always had to keep a door open. They always were straddling the fence. They always were kind of stuck in between worlds because they didn't want to miss out on something. But we're aging and we don't get no time back. And it's like, what really matters to you? So I think that you are examining yourself. And I think that this person is indirectly examining themselves. But they are kind of in a very slow paced uncovering of what do they really want. I really want to pick up that card. I really want to pick this card up and I really want to see what's under there, but I'm not. And I'm not trying to bait you. But no, this was not love. This was fear. It could have been love, but it wasn't. It was fear. I think you all may have had glimpses of love, but ultimately what took over this connection was fear. And where fear is, love cannot be. That's just how it goes. What will it be? I don't know. Because you're definitely in love now. You are loving on yourself. You are rising in love with yourself. You are understanding your value and your worth. You're moving out of your head. You're not people-pleasing. You're not just going with the status quo anymore. You want a relationship. You want love, but you want to be loved. And you want to know why you've not allowed yourself to be loved. This person is on a journey of discovery and uncovering. So could have been, but no. Yeah. So F boy, F girl. I don't even really think it's that. I think it was fear, honestly. I think it was just fear. Fear and complacency is what I got for you. So we're going to do an extended read on this. We're going to take a deeper dive into the overview. We're going to ask, how have they grown and changed? We're also going to ask what will happen next with you all. That should be interesting, but I don't want to bait you, but hopefully it's very interesting. So you like to join me in the extended, the link is going to be down below. If you would like to get a personal reading with me, I'm almost booked for November. I got a couple of days available. So get in where you fit in. Life coaching sessions the same. If you don't want to follow me anywhere, because you know my crazy behind is lost too. Why did that do that? You ain't gotta. Just stay down, y'all. It's a marathon. All right. last, but certainly never, never, ever, never, ever least. Universe. People who chose read number three. And I had a little rant that I went on because I'm sure most of y'all skipped the intro. Make sure you don't go through these readings and just pick something that feels good and is so super positive and you just claim it. Like, don't be imbalanced, because these readings are meant to bring out awareness in both parties, not just you seeking awareness on the person that's in question, but also seeking awareness on yourself. You know, when you know better, you do better. And in the same breath, don't jump on here being totally negative, blaming the other person for everything and not looking within. It's not beneficial. It's not going to help you grow. It's going to bring the same old to you until you snap out of that. Okay? So, let's look. These readings have been interesting. I haven't had a solid yes or no. Well, actually, I did, but it wasn't really a F boy, F girl. It was more so fear, but whatever. So, was this love, universe, or were they a F boy, F girl? Please keep these messages as simple and as clear as possible. Was this truly Queen of Wands or Queen of Staffs? Was this truly love, or were they a F boy, F girl, universe? Please make these messages as simple and as clear as possible. Was this truly... We have the Empress or Fertility. That's crazy. It's two pregnant people in here. The card you chose and that card I just put up there. Was this love, universe? Was this love, or were they an F boy, F girl, universe? Was this love, or were they an F boy, F girl? Please keep these messages as simple and as clear as possible. Was this love? Was this love, universe, or were they an F boy, F girl? We have the Three of Coins. Ooh. Ooh, Lord. We have Grace that came out in reverse. Was this love? Or are they an F boy, F girl? We have the Six of Coins. Was this love? We have the Princess of Coins. We have too many coins. We got the King of Coins. And we have the Princess of Arrows. Bottom of the deck, what we got? Ooh, Lord. Lord, Lord, Lord. Balance. So the reason that I said, ooh, while I was shuffling is because when I put this card up here and I leaned back, it blocked out this person. Who is this person? This is a third party situation, y'all. Get mad. I don't care. So if you're not in a third party or weren't in a third party, this ain't you. This is a third party situation. It's a very weird third party situation, though. However, so that tells you your answer right there. Excuse me. So your person had a person. Could have been a wife, a husband, somebody that they have children with. But there's something strategic about that. So that card, this card, Fertility, says Cleopatra and Caesar. And coincidentally, in a reading I did yesterday, I think I mentioned them. I referenced Cleopatra, Caesar, and Mark Antony. And the reason that I did that was because Cleopatra was very strategic. she was definitely took on the Empress energy, absolutely. But she was very grounded in the Swords energy because she was a strategist. And when I think Caesar died or when he got killed, she moved on to Mark Antony to expand her empire and to secure her empire. So the idea that she was in love with either, and she may have been, who knows? I don't know Cleopatra, do you? She may have been, but you don't go from a friend to a best friend. You don't do that unless you're strategic. Cleopatra's interest was more so in Egypt, in her empire, in securing it than it was in love. But she was a seducer. She was a sorcerer to me, of sorts, a witch. She was very witchy. So Cleopatra and Caesar, I jumped to the second card. So I think that your person is with somebody else or was with somebody else. I think that this person has some power over them, though. I think that this person may be a witch. I don't say that in a bad way, because I don't think that your person is completely unhappy with them. But I think that your person has... Caesar died. I think that your person has overstayed their space in that life. I think that your person has always had to, may have had some inclinations. Like, I don't know if this person did spells on this person to keep this person here. Enchanted them, though. Cleopatra was very much an enchantress. I don't know how they have been enchanted to stay in this space for so long, but it's like nothing that happens ever drives them away. With all those cats there, and cats have 9 lives. It's almost as if this person makes them feel like they are a part of them, like their leg to stand on, or their stability, or something about their stability is grounded in this person. And I think when this person met you, this person was, you kind of represented something that broke the spell. And I think this person had clear sight. I think that this person felt something for you that they've never felt for anyone else, because I don't think that these two people are in love. I think that Cleopatra, who's representing this other person that your person has a stable life with, the Cleopatra figure in this, I think that that person enchanted your person to keep them stuck with them. And I say stuck because that's what it is, to keep them stuck with them. To stabilize their empire, to stabilize Egypt, to stabilize their family, to stabilize their life. And no matter what happens, the cycle just keeps going. Like, your person can cheat, they don't care. Your person can leave them, they don't care. Your person can stay with them for 88 years and never marry them, they don't care. As long as they have them, that's all that matters to them. And it's by any means necessary. This, in this sense, is it's very obsessive, and this is a very transactional connection, and they objectify one another. This Cleopatra figure sees something in this person and sees that they can't do any better, or is afraid that they can't do any better, and has this person shackled to them. I would not be surprised if the Devil card is in here. And so I think that this person is like always looking over their shoulder, always sense something. But then when they met you, it's like you broke the spell. Something about you were a curse breaker or a hex breaker or something personified. You broke the spell, and this person was able to see you. And I don't know what it was about your passion and your fire, how you were divinely brought into their life, but you broke the spell. But when, as you all interacted, your person could only give you so much time, and it always left a void within you, because it's almost as if you kind of sensed something was amiss. You sensed that something wasn't right, but you never really judged it. You never asked for anything more. This may have been something that kind of was brought on by surprise, like really shocked both of you all that it happened, because it doesn't look like you were looking for them. But it seems like as time started going and moving on and you all were interacting, it became more and more, but it was never enough. And this person could never give you themselves fully because they weren't fully available. And I think that this person, this other Cleopatra, the other person, they may have gotten a whiff of you or gotten a sense of you. And there may be a spell on you and that connection by way of this person that you all share mutually. And it's so crazy because in the card that you chose, that person is blocked out. I can't see that. I can only see the cup being offered, but I can't see that person. And it just feels like, whereas you were once upon a time protected, divinely protected, it seems like things just suddenly went crazy and you weren't protected and there wasn't any grace and there wasn't any peace. And your heart was just like cast away. And I think that you begin to feel like an outsider. You begin to be like, I think there was more distance placed in between the time that you all were communicating. So maybe this Cleopatra figure was like making up stuff to do and keeping this person preoccupied or something like that, because I feel like your person was getting close to breaking free from Cleopatra. And I think that they were giving you as much time as they could, but it was still creating some division. It was still making you feel like you were left out in the cold. It wasn't enough, but this person was doing the best that they could. And I think that this person being a father or this person being this provider for this Cleopatra figure, they were trying to break free from that. And it's almost as if the story that I'm starting to see in my head is splitting apart, that Caesar turns into Mark Anthony. This is Zeus though. But even if it is Zeus, it is a breaking free. So it's almost like a transformation was happening between them, where Caesar was no longer looking at Cleopatra the same, and Caesar was dying unto himself and to that life and to thinking that that's all they could get. And because there's something subdued about your person is under a spell. Y'all need to do some spell work. Y'all need to break some curses. Black candles for everybody. I can help you with that. But yeah, that's what this is. I don't do love work no more, but like, phew. And I think that you were no longer okay with the, because the time that they could invest into you, the time that you all could talk or spend together, whatever it is, the time start dwindling more and more. It became less and less. And it was because Cleopatra was doing her thing. Cleopatra was abracadabraing the hell out of this person and continues to do it. And this person may, I mean, you have a cauldron in your hand with fire coming out of it. This person may have thought you were the witch. This person may have thought you were the enchantress. This person may have thought you were the one who had them under a spell. No, it's Cleopatra. Cleopatra is the one. It's the one. Yeah, Cleopatra's the one. And so this person, we'll switch it to Zeus now. This person understanding, has, like through you, this person began to understand that they're a god, that they're made in the image of God, that they have the power to break free, that they don't have to remain here, that there's no spell or no curse that can keep them in any place because they have power. So it's like through you, this person was reminded of their power. And I think that this person is and has looked at the balance that you brought into their life. And how you all are tied together, and the connection that you all have supersedes any curse that can be placed on them. So Cleopatra cannot blind this person to you. She can delay it. She can create havoc and chaos within it. She can... That's it. But she can't stop it. She can't stop it. And you may be the well, no, you are the one, but it's, I think she's been able to do this previously and be successful, but she can't with you because you bring balance. You bring balance. So this is bigger than F boy or F girl. The F boy or F girl is Cleopatra. It's not you and it's not your other person. However, this is something that never got off the ground. So I don't see love either. So you guys are kind of in limbo. This couldn't be true love because Cleopatra is in the way. Cleopatra is the F boy or F girl. Cleopatra is what won't set this person free. And this person is waking up from a deep slumber and realizing that they've been under a spell that they could have broken a long time ago. So it's almost as if they subconsciously gave Cleopatra the permission to keep them under a spell. And Cleopatra did something to move you all away from each other so that this person could stay asleep. So this, and this person is steadily waking up because they've met you now and you exist and there's a balance and there's a red string going through this. I can't raise the card because I'm not raising cards in any of them because I'll see underneath it and I don't want to bait anybody to go into the extended, even though I have been baiting people, but I don't want to. So, and there's a red string here. So it's like individually, you see it. Individually, this person, Princess of Arrows, which is the Page of Swords and all those butterflies, individually, this person is going through a transformation, but this person is still connected to you. And this person in this card is the same person as this person. I'm gonna raise it, whole thing. In this card, who is the same person in this card? Well, they're similar people. Yeah. Cleopatra, while I'm saying that you, the time was divided. The time was divided between you and the responsibilities that this person had with Cleopatra. Cleopatra, because now I'm seeing it totally different. Totally different. Cleopatra was understanding that something was in the way. Cleopatra understood that something was in the way. Cleopatra had a hole in her heart and was receiving less from this person as this person was going through and transforming. So not only were you feeling left out in the cold, Cleopatra was too. And Cleopatra was getting less and less and her land began to look barren. And Cleopatra knows there's a soul tied to somebody else because Cleopatra has insight. Cleopatra is a sorceress, a witch. She's very witchy. She could even be psychic. She could do tarot card readings. Cleopatra knew. Cleopatra knew. And because I can't see Cleopatra in this card, but she's coming up behind him. And I think that this person has children with them. Because I can't see her in that card, Cleopatra was trying to figure out what this person was working on or working towards or putting their energy into because Cleopatra was getting less thin all of a sudden. So quite honestly, I think I said earlier, you were getting... Like, I think as this creeped on, I think you were getting less and less energy. These cards represent Cleopatra, though. And so you may, at once upon a time, you may have been getting more of Cleopatra, what Cleopatra said is mine. You may have been, you know, picking up some of that stuff and like this person was talking more to you and, you know, balancing more with you and those things. And then... Cleopatra was like, no, we're not protecting this. We're not. Cleopatra threw a monkey wrench in here somewhere. But you're still tied to this person. This person still thinks about you. There's still emotion for you with this car behind this girl. It's like the ocean. It's like the water. There's still emotion here. There's so much here. Cleopatra's the F boy, F girl. I think your person was trying to break free, or I think it was a natural progression. I don't think they were trying to break free. I think they did break free all of a sudden, and Cleopatra was like, whoa, why is it not working? Abracadabra, why is it not working? Abracadabra, what's happening? What's happening? What's happening? And when they could no longer do it to this person, to Caesar, they did it to you. They couldn't move Caesar out the way. They couldn't get Caesar's attention. They moved you out the way. Which inadvertently affected him or them. Mm-hmm. Whoa. We're going to do an extended read on Cleopatra's behind. We're going to take a deeper dive into the overview. We're going to ask how has your person grown or changed? We're also going to ask what will happen next. If you'd like to join me over there, the link is down below. If you would like to get a personal reading with me, you can do so. Link down below. Life coaching as well. If you don't want to find out what the hell Cleopatra is up to and how what's going to happen to them, you ain't got to follow me nowhere. Just stay down, y'all. It's a marathon.